wretched system of capitalism in many different ways. And we are honored to have Brother Pierre Labusio from the Haiti Action Committee in the place to give us an update on what's going down in Haiti right now.
Thank you so much, sisters and brothers. It's an honor to stand with you today as we honor our brother, Mumia Jamal, and we call for his freedom. And in Haiti right now, many of our brothers and sisters are in jail for no reason other than they are people who stand up for their rights. They stand up against being starved to death. They stand up against being exploited. Many teachers haven't been paid in 2 years. Public school teachers not being paid in 2 years. It's a miracle that they survive by doing little odds and ends with different jobs in order to keep going. The students have taken to the streets in protest, in solidarity. And Brother Mumia, as always, whenever the time comes, he has always used his pen to stand in solidarity with the people of Haiti. Because he knows many people listen to him, many people read him, and he has used his platform to help the struggle in Haiti by putting it out to the public. And in the same way, when you give love, you receive love. So the people of Haiti love Brother Mumia, and they send him their love, their deepest affection and deepest solidarity. And they fight for Mumia to be free, even though they're in Haiti. However, they can do it through vibes and whatever they do. They do it so that Brother Mumia can be out. And I stand here as a member of the Haiti Action Committee, standing here saying with you that the Haiti Action Committee will always be out for Mumia. We'll do everything we can for Mumia to be free. We send the brother our love and our solidarity. Right now in Haiti, I won't stay too long, just to let you know, even though you don't read it in the New York Times, you don't read it in the Oakland Tribune, you don't read it in the Chronicle, but people in Haiti are not letting up the struggle. Workers are being paid $3.10 per day for a 10-hour workday. I know some people may say it's 8 hours, but the bosses get around the 8-hour provision and they make people work 10 hours or more. For these wages. Gasoline prices in Haiti is $1 more a gallon than it is in the US. So that means the cost of food, everything, the cost of transportation, everything is pretty much sky high. So as people are struggling in Haiti, we stand in solidarity with our brothers and sisters who are struggling right here in Oakland and throughout the hemisphere. And throughout the world, people are standing strong, despite the power of these imperialist forces. But the power of the people cannot be overcome. And I salute my sister from Colombia. You said it all, sis. You expressed it for all of us. So thank you so much. In solidarity always, free Mumia, Abu Jamal, freedom all. Thank you.
Thank you, Brother Pierre. And make sure you check out Haiti Action Committee. You want to see what's going on in Haiti? Look at Haiti Action Committee. Don't just trust any organization that when an emergency happens and says they're donating, Red Cross and all that, White Cloth, all that madness. Make sure you mess with the people on the real deal, you know what I mean? So we're going to keep it in the spirit of internationalism. We've heard from people in Colombia, Haiti, and now we're going to take it again to Puerto Rico, where we're actually right here, too, because that struggle is connected. We have a representative from the Oscar Lopez Defense Committee. Ricardo Ortiz is going to come in and let you know about a recently released political prisoner, Oscar Rivera Lopez, because there are political prisoners being